Good morning. I'm Sandra Mirage. The Ministry of Works and Transport is this morning hosting a conference titled Driving Towards Transformation, an Introduction to Revolutionary Traffic Enforcement Systems Aimed at Promoting Road Safety. We take you now to the Hyatt Regency Hotel in Port of Spain for live coverage of the conference on TTT, Talk City 91.1 FM, and TTT Live Online.
Standing as I invite on stage Ms. Louise Louis-Toad, who will bring today's opening prayer.
Let us bow our heads as we center our thoughts, as we come into the presence of God. Almighty God and ever-loving God, supreme creator of the universe, we bow before you this morning in reverence at this time as we come before your holy throne of grace. We give you thanks for the gift of life and the many blessings you have continuously bestowed upon us as a reminder of your faithfulness and guidance. Lord, we pray for our leaders and all persons in authority. Grant them the wisdom, strength, and enduring spirit as they continue to undertake the affairs of this nation. Mighty God, pour out fresh anointing upon them all. Today, dear God, in particular, we bring before you this U-turn launch, that you may guide the proceedings with your greatest inspiration. May each guest here and the viewing public absorb the invaluable knowledge, experiences, and put into practice that may be gained during this launch and the rollout in the weeks ahead. We pray, dear Lord, that through this undertaking, the objectives of this launch may all be achieved. Your infinite blessing would mean the success to us all gathered here today, and that we may be a living witness of your genuine love and benevolence. As we commit this launch to you, dear God, may you rekindle and transform deep within the souls of your infinite love to our fellow man. Be ever present in our lives as you reign now and forever. We give you thanks and praise, dear God, for your favor upon our lives and to live conscientiously that the good that we offer through our whole lives is proof that God is good. We ask this and all other blessings and favor upon us today and always through your precious Son.
Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. Safety is always important and it should always be our priority, ladies and gentlemen. So at this point in time, I invite our safety officer at the Hyatt, Mr. Dale Ramsey, who would start things off with our safety briefing. Please pay particular attention.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to the Hyatt Regency Trinidad. I am Dale from the Safety and Security Department. Should it become necessary to evacuate the hotel, a continuous siren will sound, followed by audible instructions to evacuate the building. When you hear, may I have your attention, please, over the public announcement system. You should proceed orderly to the exit closest to you and make your way to the muster point, proceeding along the waterfront towards the western end of the Femme Du Chalet, better known as the Breakfast Shed. Associates from the Hyatt will assist you in evacuating. Once outside, conduct a headcount for your group to ensure that everyone is accounted for. Should you believe that someone is missing, notify the hired associate in your area. Do not return to the building for any reason until the fire service stated it is safe to do so. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, and do enjoy your time with us.
Thank you. Senator, the Honorable Ruhan Sinanan, Minister of Works and Transport. The Honorable Faris Alwari, Attorney General of the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago. The Honorable Donna Cox, Minister of Communications. The Honorable Clarence Rambarat, Minister of Agriculture, Land and Fisheries. The Honorable Paula Gopi-Schoon, Minister of Trade and Industry. Senator, the Honorable Robert Lee Hunt, Minister of Public Utilities. Senator, the Honorable Alison West, Minister of Public Administration. The Honorable Fitzgerald Hines, Minister in the Ministry of the Attorney General and Legal Affairs. His Excellency Bruce Ledon, High Commissioner of the Commonwealth of Australia. The Honorable Adrian Lyons, Parliamentary Secretary in the Ministry of Works and Transport. Senator, the Honorable Avinash Singh, Parliamentary Secretary in the Ministry of Agriculture, Land and Fisheries. Senator Foster Cummings, Parliamentary Secretary in the Ministry of Rural Development and Local Government. Ms. Sonia Frances Yearwood, Permanent Secretary in the Ministry of Works and Transport. Other Permanent Secretaries and Deputy Permanent Secretaries, representatives of the Commissioner of Police, mayors, councillors, and aldermen, representatives of the Judiciary of Trinidad and Tobago, representatives of the Trinidad and Tobago Police Service, representatives of the Trinidad and Tobago Postal Services, heads of divisions of the Ministry of Works and Transport, specially invited guests, members of the media, ladies and gentlemen. And I must say a special hello to all of our viewers. We are live on TTT, as well as all our viewers who are viewing online at TTT Live. We're also live on Talk City 91.1. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome.
Co-host this morning, but you know when I'm doing this job, I don't talk too much. I usually sing. Auntie June, a special good morning to you. Chord maestro, E minor, please. La ba ba la da 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 da. La ba li bi la ba da ba ba. Everybody sing. I am glad to be here. I am making sport on behalf of the Ministry of Works and Transport. We driving towards transformation, improving the roads here in the nation. The first thing I had to sing, we going to stop the delays done by licensing. When you go down licensing office, it won't take your whole day to do your business. La ba ba da la da la la da. La ba da ye na da ye da la da ye, da la ba li bi la ba da ba ba la ye la da la da ye. And Trinidad drivers, they feel they so cool, but some of them had to go back to driving school. It's too much of nonsense going on the road, and they do not obey the driveway code. Because what I have to really admit, just know you're going to get points and a demerit. And you know when you get that, you'll complain. You go have to sit over your license again. La ba 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 ba. Ati bi la ba da. La ba la ba da. Ali bi di ba ba da la da da da. And just the other day, I went on parang. Coming back, you know I mash up my van. Because I really think it's too little drink a punch a cream I drink. Ladies and gents, I never see such. Even two drinks of punch a cream is too much. So what I had to tell you, I really think, ladies and gentlemen, never drive and drink. Even the pedestrians between me and you, you have a duty to perform too. Because I know it will implode. I don't like the way all of you does cross the road. The minister is here, he's a man of skill. If you know how much walk over the man bill, but them does watch the walk over right there, and the fool still running cross the highway. Lava ma daina. Leave me la manai. Alibi di ba ba la la da di. La la da la da. And I'm happy to look there and see we are supported by the judiciary. And when I look again, I have to say this. I'm glad to welcome the police service. This is a good initiative, of course, but it's something that you will have to enforce. The nonsense on the road, anytime they fail, police lock them up, magistrate throw them in jail. La ba 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 ba. Ali bi la ba da. Alaba la ba di, alaba la ba ba la la da la da. And there's a lovely lady right there on my right. I see her hair is red like a traffic light. Ladies and gents, don't make no mistake. Traffic light is a thing fellas love to break. But are you telling something without a doubt? The camera, they're going to take you out. So don't play the fool on this nation road. What you have to do is obey the highway code. La ba ba aina, ali bi la ba da, ali bi la ba da ba ba la da da. So I never see things so as long as I live. You know how long we need this initiative. Because you know, I like the groove, but our methods of driving have to improve. In fact, it's a lot of trouble. Some fellas like to drive defective vehicle. They have no inspection sticker in the place. And when they go on the road, they want to drag race. Well, I am your co-host, so I have to state, I do not want to exceed my mandate. In fact, what is going on? I am bringing on the people to talk and perform. And right now, I am so happy to bring on Works Permanent Secretary. This is a lady doing a lot of good. May I present to you Miss Sonia Francis Yearwood.
That was exceptional. Senator the Honorable Rohan Sinanan, Minister of Works and Transport. The Honorable Attorney General, Sifaris Alwari. Honorable Ministers, His Excellency Bruce Lendon, Australian High Commissioner. The Honorable Adrian Lyons, Parliamentary Secretary, Ministry of Works and Transport. Welcome again, Palsek. Other parliamentary secretaries, permanent secretaries, Deputy Permanent Secretaries, Representative of the Commission of Police, all other distinguished mayors and councillors, Mrs. Nadia Frank-John, Representative of the Division of Infrastructure, Quarries and the Environment, Tobago House of Assembly, heads of divisions and staff of the Ministry of Works and Transport, specially invited guests, members of the media, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. You know, you have to take a long breath after you give all those salutations. It is my distinct pleasure to welcome you to the launch of the U-turn system in Trinidad and Tobago. Today, we introduce the demerit points, new fixed penalty, and red light camera enforcement system. At the Ministry of Works and Transport, we view this day as a very special occasion because it will herald in initiatives that will drive us toward true transformation. Theme one of the central government's Vision 2030 plan outlines the need for us to work toward building a society pursuant to the goal that puts people, our most valuable asset, first. This we have reflected in our strategic plan, placing people at the center of our operations, together with our core values of accountability, innovation, integrity, and professionalism. The question we often ask ourselves is, how do we translate such a mandate into tangible realities? One of the ways the ministry has been seeking to action this theme in the transportation sector has been via the continual development of traffic law enforcement measures and strategies to regulate road use and promote road safety in Trinidad and Tobago. As such, today, what we are introducing to the nation includes a robust enforcement for offenses while ensuring a more effective and efficient disposal of matters that reach the courts. With this in mind, we move toward the ultimate end of putting people first with new systems that have been designed to encourage and promote safety on the road network, to improve the standard of driving in Trinidad and Tobago by reducing the incidence of road traffic accidents. We are hoping to deter habitual violators of traffic laws by adding additional sanctions when certain traffic laws are breached, and it is our intention to ensure that we carry out corrective and rehabilitative sanctions against violators of traffic laws. At the foundation of it all, what we are seeking to do is to orient behavior to safer driving and safer roads. As a long-standing member of the Ministry of Works and Transport, and now Permanent Secretary, for me this is a telling day, because this project has been for many years in the making, and we have had many stops and starts over the years. This latest initiative has benefited from all the necessary factors coming together, not the least of which has been a truly talented, dynamic, and dedicated team that has always been willing to go the extra mile to achieve excellence for our cause. So as I welcome you, I must take the opportunity at the same time to thank the staff of the Ministry of Works and Transport and all our stakeholders. This morning, we should all feel immense pride as together we have worked to invigorate a system that has not kept abreast with modern advancement in the industry. But even as we share the joy of this accomplishment, it is important for all of us to see that U-turn is much bigger than just us. It will take the collaborative effort of the whole of Trinidad and Tobago to bring about the benefits which can be derived from this system. While the journey to completion is nowhere near the end, today represents a very important landmark of advancement. Therefore, it is with great zeal, I want to again welcome each of you to this forum. I hope that by the end of our time together, the presentations from our stakeholders, from the Ministry of Works and Transport team, and the IC as well from the Honourable Minister of Works and Transport will fully inform us and excite us about this total transformation and the many lives that it will preserve on the roads of Trinidad and Tobago. Once again, I welcome you and I thank you.
Vital public education. Ladies and gentlemen, join me in welcoming the president of Arrive Alive, Ms. Sharon Ingerfield.
Good morning. In the essence of time, all protocol is observed. I know that's a Trini thing. But I will, in the essence of time, not go through the usual protocols. Arrive Alive would like to thank the Ministry of Works and Transport for inviting us to address you this morning, the launch of Driving Towards Transformation. It is always a pleasure to meet with you. We compliment the hard work and the tireless work of all the stakeholders that are here with us this morning. The TTPS, Trinidad and Tobago Police Service, the Judiciary, Trinidad and Tobago Post, and especially the Ministry of Works and Transport. Significant progress has been made in advancing road safety due to all your efforts. This remains very much a work in progress. There is no doubt that 4 years ago, when the Ministry of Works and Transport took the lead in this project to amend the Motor Vehicle and Road Traffic Act, together with the offices of the AG, including the introduction of the demerit point system and red light camera system, you had little knowledge that the task would have been so daunting and challenging, even sometimes frustrating. The work you have achieved has not gone unnoticed by those who truly understand the system and the gaps that existed. Some may still exist. The challenges are not to be understated. To start, firstly, closing the gaps within the policy, the processes, and the law, to gain the trust amongst the stakeholders and to network, to host the many meetings and to do and develop the many policies, processes, and implementation, to engage with the partners, the contractors, corporate TNT, and the government, stakeholders in general, to provide presentations and to field questions, often meant with cynicism and criticism. Arrive Alive has been there at some. You remained focused and ignoring the naysayers. Congratulations. You have done great work and have certainly earned my respect. Your ministry, so many bright and motivated people have given me hope, hope for Trinidad and Tobago. It is no easy task to remain motivated in the face of such challenges, but you continue on the road to deliver a system that will revolutionize the road user behavior, particularly the driver behavior on our nation's roads. Finally, we are here, and your hard work will pay off with the operationalization of the U-turn system, the demerit point system, once the law is proclaimed. There is absolutely no doubt in my mind that once the stakeholders remain committed and continue to work together tirelessly and for the common good, all our goals will be achieved, making our roads safer, positively affecting road user behavior, resulting in zero serious collisions, zero injuries, zero fatalities. As true leaders, We must never falter, and we must be reunited and unrelenting in this mission, since never before we continue to experience the needless loss of life on our roads and, unfortunately, in our country. Each and every one of you who has brought this monumental task to fruition is a leader in your own right. Never allow anyone to intimidate you, nor to compromise your integrity. Martin Luther King once said, "The ultimate measure of a man is not where he stands in moments of comfort and convenience, but where he stands at times of challenge and controversy." None of us must allow what is popular and controversial to intimidate us from doing what is right. This U-turn system, with the introduction of the demerit point system, will transform the safety on our roads, since once fully implemented and enforced, it will transform road user behavior. I repeat, once we continue to do our jobs, to remain absolutely transparent and honest, it will change the mindset of drivers, some of whom, and up to now, truly believe that they are above the law. The new system will ensure that errant drivers will be retrained by rehabilitative drivers' education. Training and education is vital, and this new law will make it mandatory. Arrive Alive's mantra has always been, to fix our roads, you fix our country. Simply said, this is because there are five pillars that support road safety. Education and enforcement come under pillar four, safer road users. This is just one of the five pillars. Today I will not discuss the responsibilities of pillar two, safer roads and mobility, road design, construction and maintenance, since you're all fully aware of my sentiments regarding same. Arrive Alive as a road safety NGO will never blame the victims of road traffic collisions. We will, however, hold our leaders accountable for road user education and for enforcing our law. The U-turn system and the demerit point system will support our law enforcement agencies and officers via technology. We must install those cameras, and we must bring the spot speed camera law to Parliament and install enough cameras and provide the officers with as many electronic fixed penalty notice devices that are required to support the enforcement of our current driving population. We must maintain all our equipment and consistently train the staff and officers of all our enforcement centers. In other words, to support driving towards transformation, the staff and officers of all the direct stakeholders of this system must have access to everything they require, from fingerprint paper, to computers and printers, to the electronic fixed penalty notice devices, the 15 LiDAR speed guns, as well as the breathalyzer units, and all the cameras and skilled law enforcement officers and staff to do their job. We must keep them motivated, and then we must hold them accountable. We must ensure that the annual budget allocations are made and funds provided to meet these recurrent costs. With the political will, we will all achieve our goal to save lives. We have made tremendous strides over the last 10 years, and I must compliment all of you. Too many names to mention. Your permanent secretary, Ms. Sonia Francis Yearwood, your legal team, the Traffic Enforcement Center, the IT and communications team, and the engineering, construction, and design teams within the ministry, as well as the Honorable Minister Rohan Sinanan, who continues to support the cause of road safety, often in challenging circumstances. Other stakeholders, the Trinidad and Tobago Police Service, the Judiciary, the TT Post, the AG's Office. We salute all your efforts and thank you for the part you have played in saving lives, in saving us from serious injuries, and achieving this significant milestone in our mission to revolutionize road user behavior in our country. Thank you.
Call the maestro, please. It had a crash just the other day. 4 people died down on the highway. Somebody say, move all the lampposts, the pine to the highway, the post to close. Well, ladies and gents, I go tell you flat, the minister, he ain't have no money for that. Lampposts ain't kill anybody yet. Is your reckless driving that cause road death? La ba ba da 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 la da la da da la da da la da da. I am very happy. I had to declare, when I look and see all these ministers here, it is my greatest pleasure to introduce a distinguished man of letters. This gentleman, I had to confess, he is the MP for San Fernando West. So right now, I am very happy to invite on stage my Attorney General, Mr. Faris Al-Rawi.
Distinguished cabinet colleagues, permanent secretaries, distinguished members of the diplomatic corps, honorable ladies and gentlemen, our specially invited guests, members of the protective services, good morning. Minister Rohan Sinanan is a man of great talent. You may not know this, but he's also a huge literary fan. He is, in fact, the biggest fan of The Adventures of Tom Sawyer. Written in 1876, the story of Tom Sawyer and that imagery of him being assigned by virtue of punishment to paint the fence resulted in Tom Sawyer turning the situation on its head. In that situation, Tom Sawyer ended up with 12 boys painting the fence for him while he went off to do other things described as enjoyable. That, ladies and gentlemen, is our Tom Sawyer. Rohan Sinanan makes work look easy because he's a hard-working man who is a multiplier. In the Ministry of Works and Transport, we have 2 capable ministers, Adrian Leonce and Rohan Sinanan. But the team that went to work really was joined by a larger team. I was telling Sharon Inglefield, whom I pay the utmost compliment today and every day, we're in constant communication by WhatsApp and otherwise, and she is a true advocate for change and for decency and propriety in our country. And ladies and gentlemen, I ask you to give her a round of applause this morning, please. In the combination of efforts, as I was saying a little bit earlier, and in looking at the Tom Sawyer approach, you realize Minister Sinanan had to save a little ink, so you won't see my name on the program this morning, but I'll connect the dots for you in just a moment. Trinidad and Tobago, our Motor Vehicle and Road Traffic Act, Chapter 4850, was born in 1934 by Act of Parliament Number 42. I, as a parliamentarian now for 10 years, witnessed 20 years of analysis paralysis. On coming into the Office of Attorney General, crime was the number one focus for me. And the elements of crime have to be dealt with in a whole-of-government approach. We've just heard the Chamber of Commerce ask to be thinking outside the box, and permit me to address that now in the few moments that I have. You see, for 20 years, we engaged in this Act of Parliament from 1934, and lying there was a brilliant section Section 100. Section 100 of that 1934 law allows for the use of regulations. Successive governments insisted on birthing something called a motor vehicle authority. In fact, in the 5 years and 3 months I spent in opposition, I watched us spend years trying to bring the motor vehicle and road authority into existence, and then in a previous government as well. So at the AG's office, we took on the task to find a way to bring simple majority legislation in a common sense way. And this morning, I must pay a huge compliment to the rational, logical thinking of our Chief Justice, Ivor Archie. And if you look into the annual speeches of the Chief Justice year on year, you'll see a few commonsensical things. You see, ladies and gentlemen, you have this pamphlet in your package. And at page 5 of your pamphlet, you will see what I'm talking about with Tom Sawyer, with Section 100, and with crime. And permit me to connect those dots. There's a little chart. And in that chart, you will notice that we have set out the statistics for the last 5 law terms of the types of cases filed in the magistrate's court. Put quite simply, every year, 146,000 cases get to the magistrate's court. We want justice. We want a consequence to an event, either an acquittal or a conviction. If you do the crime, you must pay the time. But that did not happen and does not happen in our country because of the sheer volume of cases. 43 magistrates sitting in 12 courts dealing with 146,000 cases per year. How do you get justice when 60% of it goes into the backlog and 40% of it is shifted around? When we came into office, we had these 43 magistrates with that caseload in 12 courts. And importantly, we had clerks of the peace who were not lawyers. We had no computer systems in the courts. We had no recording of evidence in the courts. We were paper-based manual system. There was no magisterial protection. We had 36 judges, 12 court of appeal judges, 36 in the high court. We had no criminal division, no road traffic division, no family division, no children division, no petty courts division. The age of retirement at 65 years, and the laws of Trinidad and Tobago lying unoperationalized for decades. So there was born the theory behind today's other end of the equation. Making sure that the criminal justice system works so that crime, as one of the main issues in our country, can be tackled. And today, I can tell you, having been the author of the law in 2016, 2017, 2018, 2019, we are now in this position. From 36 judges to 64 in the High Court, legislatively. From 12 Court of Appeal judges to 15. From clerks of the peace who are not legally trained officers, who are now registrars of the magistrate's court, to electronic environment in the magistrate's court, to each magisterial officer having a 5-to-1 support team to magistrates, to a digitized environment. But most importantly, and connecting today's pieces of the puzzle, 146,000 cases just won't do it. And on page 5 of your pamphlet, you will see 104,000 cases each year are Motor Vehicle and Road Traffic Act cases. So what we did is to simply introduce Section 20 A, B, and C of the law, make the user of the law on the road a conditionality, a privilege. You don't have a right to drive on the road, you have a license to drive on the road. And then birth the regulations, red light enforcement, spot speed legislation, it's in Parliament, Sharon. It will be dealt with this month. Cameras for enforcement, demerit points. But what does that do with crime? From 146,000 cases, You take away 104,000 immediately by launching this today. You then take away 26,000 preliminary inquiries. And how about if you take away 8,500 ganja cases? You know what that means, ladies and gentlemen? Your load of 146,000 cases drops to 8,500 cases using the same 43 magistrates in the same 12 courts, but this time, clerks of the peace are registrars, a criminal division has been born, a family division has been born, a children's division has been born, the petty civil court is about to be born, judges have gone from 36 to 64, 12 to 15, 5-to-1 ratio support system inside of the magistracy, computerization in the magistracy, judiciary, technologically speaking, with licensing authority, technologically speaking, with traffic authority, technologically speaking, with TT Post, technologically speaking, with the people of Trinidad and Tobago, because with a red light camera, with spot speed enforcement, with radio frequency identification tags, which are coming next, and which we are very far ahead on, you now have eyes everywhere. What does that mean? Hardly ever do we see somebody making their getaway on a donkey cart, a horse, or a skateboard. Usually it involves a car. It means that with RF tags, with spot speeds, and with cameras, we now have digital evidence of number plate, owner, location, time, and therefore evidence in a court of law for serious crime. You see, today is not only about easing the system of road traffic and making roads safer. That's a huge part, obviously. We saw what 6 speed guns did to the culture of driving in Trinidad and Tobago. We saw what a law to impose seatbelts did to Trinidad and Tobago and how many lives have been saved, breathalyzers, etc. Today is also about tackling the number one issue of crime in our country. That is why we have digitized every driver's license, every record for ownership of motor vehicle and changes. We have pushed for a cashless environment. We have digitized all passport information. At the Attorney General's office, we've tied that into birth certificate, death certificate, marriage certificate, adoption certificate, so that you now tie the pieces of the puzzle together as we get to transforming Trinidad and Tobago. Today is about deciding for yourselves what vision Trinidad and Tobago ought to have. What vision ought to be prosperous for us all. Today is not about an election year. Today is about recognizing that as we took the law 2015, 16, 17, 18, 19, we operationalized the law at the same time. We trained the entire division. We established the computer networks. We linked the data. We digitized the data. We brought on the officers. And I can tell you now, I just showed my 2 colleagues, Ministers Rambarat and Minister Hines, I have drafted the law already to deal with the backlog. There are 250,000 cases in backlog in the motor vehicle and road traffic arena, and I am going to legislatively treat with that so that we eliminate the backlog. Why? A magistrate's time is precious. The court operating under criminal proceedings rules for the first time ever under our government, that is a precious thing. You see, ladies and gentlemen, the narrative in our country is to focus on negatives. I am sure many of you perhaps didn't think about this program in the context of crime, law enforcement, judicial time, magisterial time, but now you understand the connection of the dots, put quite simply, as the application of common sense. I wish to pay tribute this morning as I end to the extremely capable people in our public service of Trinidad and Tobago. Led by Minister Sinanan, led by Chief Justice Archie, led by Minister Robert Lehunt and his predecessors in managing the TT Post equation, standing with Minister Hines in the role as the Office of the Attorney General, Ministry of Legal Affairs, Minister Stuart Young in managing the National Security, National Operations Center, Eyes Everywhere platform, this has been a whole of government approach. I was at the House of Mourning for young Dr. Sharma a couple days in a row, and I heard a past parliamentarian give a story which I've now given 3 days in a row, and I think it fit to say it again. The story is of a hummingbird flying away from Medina because there was a raging fire. And the hummingbird was pelting towards the Red Sea, flying at full capacity, heart beating. Got to the Red Sea, turned around, and was flying on his way back to Medina when the Almighty stopped the hummingbird and said, "Little bird, where are you going? Surely you will die. Your heart rate is too high." And the little bird said, "Medina is on fire, and I need to go and out that fire." And the Almighty said to him, "Well, how do you propose to out the fire, little bird?" He says, "Well, I went to the Red Sea, and I have a drop of water in my beak." And he said to him, "Well, how is that drop of water going to out the fire at Medina?" And he said, "Well, I know what I'm doing as to my part, and my drop of water will make that difference." Challenge to Trinidad and Tobago. How many of us are capable of wanting to take that drop of water back to the raging fire? I know Sharon Inglefield is. I know Rohan Sinanan is. I know Robert LeHunt. I know my ministers of finance. I see Alison West here in providing the funding for this. Because Sharon, you raised something very important. You call for resources. Ladies and gentlemen, we lost 96% of our revenue, and we did this. We did it in 4 years. We took 40 years of work and did it in 4 years. Each person with a drop of water in the beak headed back to that raging fire in Medina, in our case, Trinidad and Tobago, challenged us all. Let's do our own part. That includes paying your fair share. All the love in the world, we know the saying in Trinidad and Tobago, it takes cash to care. Unfortunately, cash comes from people complying in the system, which is why Ministry of Works and Transport, we are going cashless. As AG's office goes cashless and online payments, within a matter of weeks, online payments will be in place to facilitate this entire system. To Mr. Marvin Gonzalez, one of the hardest working people I have met in the public service of Trinidad and Tobago, I wish to say to you, sir, congratulations for your hard work, and to your minister for his open door policy. You see that lovely smile that Rohan walks with, and his wit and charm, his Tom Sawyerist sort of approach to life, he makes it look easy. And when you're in an environment where you can prosper because you have the support of your ministerial colleagues, it makes it all the much better. Ladies and gentlemen, I thank you for this opportunity to give my small part of the equation. There's a lot more to be told, and congratulations to our U-turn system on a job well done. Thank you.
Thank you very much for such a powerful statement. Definitely a lot of important points that we need to take notice of there. Ladies and gentlemen, as we move forward with today's program, it is my pleasure to welcome on stage Miss Star Jacob, known for her powerful voice and scintillating performances. We would like to invite her on stage to perform a national classic. And if you know it, you can sing along, entitled "God Bless Our Nation." Let's give her a warm welcome.
Good morning. All protocols observed.
Mm-hmm.
So you agree with me that she's known for her powerful voice and scintillating performances. So we can do better than that, ladies and gentlemen. Right, yeah, we're going good. And we take our pride at the Ministry of Works and Transport in the distinguished staff that we have and the staff who have supported the vision of our minister, doing more with less. And today I'm proud to say that we have kept and we have supported his mandate, and following on what our distinguished AG has said, we have delivered on a key project which will impact many lives and many organizations and state agencies and organizations across Trinidad and Tobago. And it's indeed my pleasure to introduce our next speaker, and I do take pride. He's a distinguished son of the soil. His name is Mr. Marvin Gonzalez, and he's the director of the Legal Services Unit at the Ministry of Works and Transport. A trained attorney at law, Mr. Gonzalez spearheaded the process for the legislative amendments to the Motor Vehicles and Road Traffic Act to facilitate the introduction of a demerit point system, new fixed penalty ticketing system, and red light camera enforcement system, which we all call combined the U-turn system. Ladies and gentlemen, for over 8 years, Marvin Gonzalez, as I call him, has demonstrated a key interest in modernizing traffic laws in Trinidad and Tobago. In fact, he played a very significant role in the introduction of breathalyzer laws, the mobile phone regulations, and the use of speed guns in Trinidad and Tobago. So it's indeed my pleasure to introduce him today, but before he comes to the podium, I'd like to invite your attention to the screens for a short video presentation.
An elderly woman was killed today when an army truck collided with the car.
30-year-old Keon Lewis,
a Coast Guard officer, is dead following a crash.
25-year-old Angelia Jackson was also killed when the vehicle in which she was driving.
On the 11th of February 2009, we got that dreaded call from one of my son's friends. He had been in a serious collision. Jonathan died in the ambulance on the way to the hospital. And the rest is history.
A driver lost control of his vehicle. The car rolled about three times. The scent of alcohol was coming from the vehicle. So we were pretty sure that alcohol is a major contributor.
Pain has no color. Pain has no religion. Pain bears no boundaries. So we'll slow down and change our behavior.
Safety is the only option out there. We all have a right to use the road, but we all have a right to use the road safely.
Let's make a U-turn towards your safety, my safety, our safety.
The Honorable Attorney General of Trinidad and Tobago, Sir Faris Alwari, Senator the Honorable Rohan Sinanan, Minister of Works and Transport, members of the Cabinet, Mrs. Sonia Francis Yearwood, Permanent Secretary in the Ministry of Works and Transport, other Permanent Secretaries, Deputy Permanent Secretaries, colleagues in the Ministry of Works and Transport, heads of division of the Ministry of Works and Transport, specially invited guests, members of the media, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. With a belief that our roads and our country can be made safer for all our citizens, in 2016, the Legal Services Unit of the Ministry of Works and Transport, together with our colleagues from the Ministry of the Attorney General and Legal Affairs, collaborated and established a comprehensive policy and a legislative framework to amend the Motor Vehicles and Road Traffic Act to achieve the following. The decriminalization of a number of traffic offenses and the establishment of a system of traffic violations. A new fixed penalty traffic ticketing system, a red light camera and enforcement system, and a demerit point system. The legislation was passed in both Houses of Parliament, assented to on July 27, 2017, and is currently pending proclamation. From 2017 to present, the Ministry of Works and Transport led a multi-agency implementation committee comprising of the Judiciary of Trinidad and Tobago, the Trinidad and Tobago Police Service, the Trinidad and Tobago Postal Corporation, and the Ministry of the Attorney General and Legal Affairs. The main objective of the committee was to ensure that the operational readiness of all the agencies for the successful implementation of this landmark piece of legislation. From the onset, the Ministry of Works and Transport recognized that in order for such legislation to be effectively implemented, and to achieve overall transformation for a better society, all of the necessary agencies must be seamlessly connected on a custom-made software management system for sharing data, as well as the modification of old business practices to make way for more technological advances. There was no way we could have operationalized this key piece of legislation utilizing current business practices, for to do so would have led to eventual failure. The name U-Turn was coined to describe this custom-made software management solution and given the significant impact it will have across the society. This U-Turn project was led by a group of dedicated, passionate, and loyal employees in the Ministry of Works and Transport, the Judiciary, the Trinidad and Tobago Police Service, TT Post, whose sole motivation and vision is for a better public service and a better Trinidad and Tobago. A vision that was never distracted or daunted by previous attempts at modernization or transformation, but one that is rooted in a philosophy that as a country, we can aspire to be among the best in the world and among other nations of this blue Caribbean Sea. As a country, we will continue to chart our own destiny and do our part in perfecting our society for our children, future generations, for which they can all be proud. For me personally, the experience of conceptualizing, managing, and promoting this project over the last 3 years has taught me so much about this country. So many realities that I was never fully cognizant of. For example, the deep level of cynicism that exists among a wide cross-section of our citizens who often doubt our ability as a nation to be the best we can possibly be. So many of our fellow citizens have resigned themselves to the belief that our destiny will always be characterized by incompetence, corruption, and mismanagement. Therefore, we doubt our ability to bring into effect in Trinidad and Tobago a renewed and transformed licensing division, a demerit point system, a red light camera enforcement system, and a new fixed penalty ticketing system that will not only usher in the dawn of revolutionary and modern law enforcement for our safety, but improved administrative systems in Trinidad and Tobago that will bring government services closer to the citizens. As citizens, we should also challenge ourselves to make a U-turn from this mindset of pessimism and self-doubt, if only for the sake of our children and future generations. During this presentation, you will be given an insight into how this U-turn software management system will modernize and replace old entrenched systems and make way for new technological advances. This system will result in efficient operations across key state agencies and will no doubt redound to the benefit of all citizens in so many ways. For example, safer roads, greater access to justice, accessible services at our licensing division. There are so many benefits to be derived by the people of Trinidad and Tobago, some of which we cannot expound upon because of national security considerations. We do hope that at the end of this presentation, you will have a holistic appreciation of the technological platform that we have established for the implementation of modern progressive legislation in Trinidad and Tobago in the quest for fashioning a better society for all our citizens. The first video presentation, the new fixed penalty traffic ticketing system in Trinidad and Tobago. The first presentation will show you that U-turn improvement or that software system will bring to an area of traffic management and enforcement. Ladies and gentlemen, this system has been with us for over 40 years and essentially is governed by legislation that was useful for its purpose. At its time, it was introduced in Trinidad and Tobago. It served this purpose for allowing drivers an opportunity to pay smaller fines for some traffic offenses rather than being placed before a court and to overwhelm the judicial system. Unfortunately, this system morphed into a nightmare for the judiciary and became a main contributor to the very problems it was created to address, an overburdened judicial system. To summarize, the reality is that hundreds of thousands of traffic cases go before the courts due to the non-payment of tickets by errant drivers. Thousands of lost man hours are spent by police officers, traffic wardens, as well as court staff in dealing with these matters on a daily basis, whilst the wheels of justice grind slowly and citizens suffer as a result of the pace at which justice is delivered in our courts. Some of the key features of the new fixed penalty ticketing system in the U-turn module are as follows. More convenient locations nationwide to pay traffic tickets, example, approved TT Post centers, mobile devices to issue electronic tickets, thereby creating real-time tech connectivity between law enforcement officers, the Judiciary of Trinidad and Tobago, and the Licensing Division. Reduction in time and other back-end work directly related to the management of the system. The decriminalization of a number of traffic offenses and the introduction of administrative sanctions to be imposed for non-payment of traffic tickets. A new traffic enforcement center to administer the system so that it keeps up to date with modern standards of effective management.
Unsafe driving is a major risk to the safety of all road users. Be it using mobile phones whilst driving, exceeding speed limits, driving under the influence of alcohol, or simply not wearing a seatbelt, these behaviors far too often lead to tragic road collisions which take the lives of our loved ones.
We at the Trinidad and Tobago Police Service welcome the introduction of the U-turn system as part of a technology-driven platform designed to improve the road traffic enforcement landscape. A cross-functional team that re-engineered the entire process of the fixed penalty notice system, identifying its strengths, areas for improvements, and overall functionality to ensure that key users will be able to benefit from the use of traffic enforcement technology built upon more reliable processes for accountability and the management of resources. The TTPS, in collaboration with the Ministry of Works and Transport, is excited to move away from an archaic system to a robust IT platform for real-time inter-agency information sharing between law enforcement, licensing, the newly established Traffic Enforcement Center, and the Judiciary of Trinidad and Tobago.
Law enforcement officers will be outfitted with a device that connects them to the U-turn software. This allows them to perform various functions, including verifying the authenticity of a driver's permit, registration status of a vehicle, and checking for court hearings. It also captures photographic evidence of a traffic offense and will be able to notify the law enforcement officer whether there may be outstanding warrants in relation to a driver. The first major benefit of this system is the elimination of the need for four copies of a ticket for issuance. The new electronic fixed penalty notice device is easy to use and fully portable at the size of a smartphone, and officers need only print one ticket for the offending motorist. And the paper issued is able to withstand the elements such as water.
Gone are the days of officers having to struggle to ensure four pieces of carbon paper are in place to write a ticket. Previously, this had to be filled out in quintuplet, one original and four copies. This was a source of major frustration to both law enforcement officers and motorists, who would sometimes have to wait whilst an officer chases their carbon paper blown away by the wind.
Another of the system's major highlights is the real-time dissemination of information. As soon as a ticket is entered into the U-turn system, it is accessible for the Traffic Enforcement Center for processing.
One of the major benefits of the new U-turn system is the real-time connectivity for inter-agency information sharing. What this means is when the officers are out on the road with our electronic ticketing devices, when we are accessing driver and vehicle records, we are directly accessing accurate licensing records to ensure that the ticketing process is efficient and accurate. Another benefit of the digital platform is that officers on the road with the electronic devices will now be able to detect if a driver has reached the maximum threshold of the merit points on the driver's permits. This can result in an errant driver being arrested on site.
In stakeholder consultations, one of the major concerns raised was the legibility of information on handwritten tickets due to varying levels of officers' penmanship. The digital wireless connectivity and GPS location features of the electronic fixed penalty notice devices allow the necessary information fields to be auto-generated from the licensing database together with offense selection.
Because there is no writing necessary by the law enforcement officer, the time taken to issue a traffic ticket utilizing an electronic fixed penalty notice device has been reduced from an average of 10 to 20 minutes to a maximum of 2 to 3 minutes.
Under the previous system, officers spent a lot of time engaged in a number of tasks after issuing a fixed penalty notice to drivers while on patrol. This included manually re-entering the details of each notice issued into various traffic books, such as the traffic offense and casebook registers. Officers will also need to ensure that the physical second copy of the ticket is transported to the district magistrate's court to be manually booked into their system.
So if a ticket was issued in Toko, officers would have to drive to the court jurisdiction of the Sangre Grande Magistrate's Court to deliver the copy of the fixed penalty notice for it to be paid. The motorist was also required to pay the ticket in the district court where the offense occurred. The U-turn system eases this burden since the fixed penalty notice is created digitally, allowing for immediate sharing with the magistrate's court and court prosecutors if a notice to contest is filed. This allows officers to be where we want them to be, out on the roads, protecting and serving, rather than behind a desk.
The U-turn system will improve accountability and lessen the likelihood of corrupt practices.
One of the key shortcomings of the previous system was that traffic tickets could suddenly disappear from the system at various stages. The U-turn system easily counters this since each fixed penalty notice is digitally generated and can be easily digitally traced in the system to verify its status and identify all parties and devices involved in the operation. Supervisors can also track officers' performances and drivers' behavioral patterns.
With the notice to contest feature, officers utilizing the U-turn system will be immediately notified of the court date, location, and defendant contesting the matter.
The previous system did little to deter drivers who continuously engaged in unsafe and illegal road use, with some drivers receiving a ticket for the same offense almost weekly. We welcome the new demerit point system to serve as a deterrent to errant drivers on our nation's roadways.
The driver demerit points system assists law enforcement officers in dealing with repeat offenders. Under the antecedent behavior consequence model, the U-turn system allows quick identification of a driver's habitual patterns and creates an effective deterrence under the threat of disqualification or sanctions by cumulative offense detections. The fixed penalty notice or traffic ticket is not just an opportunity for a driver to pay a fine as a consequence of a breach of the law, but it is also an opportunity for drivers to be reminded of the importance of adhering to road traffic laws.
We at the TTPS and the Ministry of Works and Transport consider one traffic death to be one too many. We will continue to collaborate to achieve the goal of bringing road fatalities down to zero. Every life matters.
We'll be the central agency that connects the judiciary of Trinidad and Tobago, the TTPS, traffic wardens, TT Post, and the ordinary citizens of the U-turn software system. Utilizing this modern technological platform, the center will be responsible for the effective management of the fixed penalty ticketing system, the demerit point system, and the new ticketing system, processing data from the red light camera system to generate citation notices before they are couriered by TT Post. The center will also facilitate the transmittance of electronic case files and data directly to the courts for the hearing of matters when drivers request court hearings. The center will also have the capacity to receive court orders via the U-turn system. With its world-class technological systems, the center will play a key role in the modernization drive within the licensing division.
As part of the modernization of the traffic system will be the introduction of a traffic enforcement center. The traffic enforcement center plays a central role in the implementation of the provisions of the Motor Vehicles and Road Traffic Act of 2017. It will now be a permanent feature in the landscape of traffic law enforcement and back-end management for the new systems to be introduced.
The traffic enforcement center will be a major hub for real-time connectivity for data sharing, with the processing of red light and speed citation notices, the allocation and overall management of the demerit point system, and the administration of the new fixed penalty ticketing system in Trinidad and Tobago.
It is the gateway through which the software management system known as U-turn shares real-time information among key state agencies, including the Trinidad and Tobago Police Service, the Judiciary of Trinidad and Tobago, and the Trinidad and Tobago Postal Corporation.
The Traffic Enforcement Center is the first of its kind in Trinidad and Tobago. Never before has a central agency existed to monitor and manage a technological platform that allows for a collaborative relationship among key state agencies.
U-turn will, among other things, allow for the use of handheld devices by law enforcement officers to issue electronic traffic tickets. At the center, fixed penalty processing officers will monitor all fixed penalty tickets from the time they are issued to when they are paid. Along with their colleagues, the demerit points processing officer will apply demerit points where necessary.
These new carbonless ticket books mirror the electronic ticket, and the issuance, administration, and audit of these books will be led by the Traffic Enforcement Center to ensure full compliance by law enforcement officers.
Law enforcement officers can issue a manual ticket only in instances where the technology has failed and the officer must enter that ticket into the U-turn system within 24 hours. This information is immediately transmitted to the Traffic Enforcement Center, TT Post, and TTPS.
The Traffic Enforcement Center acts as the human eye to ensure that the system operates in accordance with the legislation. It advises the licensing authority on the suspension of permits and the freezing of driving and vehicle records for non-payment of traffic tickets.
The red light camera enforcement system will use automated detection mechanisms which will photograph and record all vehicles violating the red light. These red light processing officers will review the raw footage to determine if a breach did occur. An inspection officer is the final step in determining if a breach did or did not occur. A citation notice is then generated and delivered via TT Post courier service to the registered owner or owners of the vehicle. The owner of the vehicle has the opportunity to file a notice to contest via the online customer portal within the stipulated time frame. The information is then transmitted to the Traffic Enforcement Center and an electronic case file is prepared. This electronic case file is then transmitted to the Judiciary Magistrates Court via the U-turn software. Once the court determines a ruling, the result of the case will be transmitted to the Traffic Enforcement Center and the driver's record is updated.
No longer will the court be required to transmit information to the licensing authority using a paper-based system. This will eliminate the practice of citizens falsifying information about court convictions and orders to get duplicate driving permits. If a person is convicted of an offense or traffic violation that carries demerit points, the prescribed points shall be recorded against the driver's record.
The demerit points register has two categories of drivers: newly licensed drivers and experienced drivers. The number of demerit points accumulated also determines the period of suspension for a driver. Once the demerit point officer has determined that a driver is due for disqualification, a letter is forwarded from the Traffic Enforcement Center via TT Post Courier to the owner of the vehicle, indicating the licensing authority's intention to impose necessary sanctions. The offender will now have 14 days to respond to the licensing authority to show cause as to why he or she should not be disqualified.
Under the new legislation, driving an uninspected vehicle carries 9 demerit points. We can see in the case of a newly licensed driver, where the threshold is 7 or more demerit points, that person can easily have their permit suspended for a period of 6 months from one traffic stop.
The engine room of the Traffic Enforcement Center comprises a cadre of highly skilled analysts who underwent a rigid recruitment system inclusive of polygraph testing and background checks.
To ensure transparency and maintain the integrity of the U-turn system, the Traffic Enforcement Center will be subjected to robust internal and external audits to deter corrupt practices. In the near future, I envision that the Traffic Enforcement Center and the U-turn system will have a profound impact on the driving culture in Trinidad and Tobago.
The Traffic Enforcement Center will therefore guide Trinidad and Tobago into a new era of 21st century traffic enforcement by utilizing modern technological advancements that places our Twin Island Republic on par with other developed countries around the world.
TT Post is a state-owned postal and courier service company with a long-standing history that spans delivery of mail and postal articles throughout households throughout Trinidad and Tobago. Under the new U-turn system, drivers will now be able to pay their traffic tickets at approved TT Post centers. No longer will a driver have to endure the hassle of visiting the particular magistrate's court located in the jurisdiction where the traffic offense was committed. Additionally, payments will be made via cash, links, or coming soon, online payments. This partnership with TT Post will ensure the modernization of the business processes involved in the issuance and payment of traffic tickets under the fixed penalty traffic ticketing system.
The Trinidad and Tobago Postal Corporation is pleased to partner with the Ministry of Works and Transport in this transformative U-turn project that will positively impact the lives of every citizen in Trinidad and Tobago. Through this collaborative effort, TT Post is helping to modernize a system that was burdened with inconvenience and much hassle. In the past, paying for a traffic ticket was a challenge, and this inefficiency placed a considerable burden on the judicial system, with thousands of traffic tickets being left unpaid. For example, a person who lives in Cedrus and is issued a traffic ticket while vacationing in Tobago, he or she is required to go through the hassle of returning to Tobago, visiting the said magistrate court to pay their traffic ticket. The good news is, that is about to change.
All of us here at TT Post are so excited to be part of the Ministry of Works and Transport initiative. We're excited because TT Post is to provide two very critical functions to support the U-turn project. Firstly, TT Post will deliver citation notices, notifications of pending sanctions, and any other official documents from the Ministry's Traffic Enforcement Center to recipients nationwide. This all will be done via TT Post couriers. Secondly, TT Post will serve as a payment center where citizens will have access to 12 approved locations directly connected to the U-turn system to to pay for their citation notices or tickets. This will allow for greater convenience and ease of payment via the use of cash or links.
The ministry expects a higher compliance rate for the payment of traffic tickets and a significant reduction in the number of traffic matters going before the courts as a result of non-payments of traffic tickets.
We are happy to announce that in the very near future, our valued customers can look forward to more approved locations, making payments via credit card and through online payment platforms. TD Post has completed a number of initiatives to prepare for the start of this project. For example, all our payment locations have been updated and equipped with accessibility directly to the U-turn system. All our staff have been trained and are ready to serve the public. And our key touch points with the general public, such as our website, have been updated with the relevant information on this new and exciting project. We invite you to learn more about the new payment options and processing by visiting our website at www.ttpost.net.
TD Post supports the transformation of the licensing division. In fact, there are many more initiatives to follow, and as a partner in change, TD Post is excited to be a part of this journey. This collaboration facilitates the opportunity for continual innovation, such as the implementation of a modern track and trace system, which is ongoing. This feature will allow for transparency and accountability in the delivery of citation notices and vehicle certified copies.
U-turn could not have come at a better time. This project will not only revolutionize the way we conduct business within Trinidad and Tobago, but will also change our road culture to save lives in the future.
The judiciary of Trinidad and Tobago is an autonomous arm of the state and will continue to function independently. The judiciary stands to be a major beneficiary from the recent amendments to the Motor Vehicles and Road Traffic Act, particularly the improvements made to the fixed penalty ticketing system and the introduction of a demerit point system aimed at repeat driving offenders and the decriminalization of many traffic offenses to traffic violations. Under the U-turn system, the courts will now have direct access to communicate with the licensing division via the Traffic Enforcement Center and directly with law enforcement officers in case management. Added to other recent improvements and changes in the judicial arm of the state, citizens can now look forward to an acceleration in the administration of justice in Trinidad and Tobago, and we at the Ministry of Works and Transport a privilege to be part of this transformation drive.
The judiciary plays a critical role in the implementation of the U-turn system. The new law requires a person who has been issued a traffic ticket or a citation notice to file a notice to contest, or a notice request in a court hearing if such a person wishes to contest the content of a ticket or citation notice. Ticket matters will no longer automatically go before the court due to non-payment of the stipulated fines. The court will no longer be saddled with the burden of being the sole institution to receive payments for traffic tickets.
The Honorable Chief Justice, Mr. Justice Ivor Archie, in his opening address at the 2015-16 law term, spoke on the performance of the courts and the number of new matters filed versus the number of cases disposed, and lamented on the not too encouraging rate of case dispositions.
More significantly, our disposal to filings ratio is stuck at 0.67. Traffic matters accounted for 56,744 of the new filings. Magistrates do not need to be dealing with minor traffic matters like tickets. They should be doing case management and trials. The technology exists for smart licenses and immediate electronic citations. Fines should be payable online.
It was therefore a welcome initiative when the Ministry of Works and Transport met with the judiciary to present the ministry's plan for improving the efficiency of the fixed penalty ticketing system by introducing a demerit point system, red light camera technology legislation, and traffic enforcement systems.
When the Motor Vehicle and Road Traffic Act was enacted in 2017, the judiciary had already embarked on its internal transformation drive to reform its processes and reduce administrative and procedural delays in the amendment linked unquestionably to this objective. Currently under the law, when a law enforcement officer issues a fixed penalty traffic ticket, the defendant must go to the courthouse in the district where the offense occurred to pay the fine. If payment is not made, the alleged offender has to appear before the traffic court within the said district.
The present system is onerous on both the customer and on the courts. Besides having the responsibility of processing payments on behalf of the state, unpaid tickets are transferred to the court's list as traffic cases. The number of traffic cases filed in the 2018-2019 law term, excluding July, stands at over 85,000 new cases. Overall, 60.4% of all the cases filed at the magistrate's courts are traffic cases. Court lists are saturated with traffic matters, which contribute to the backlog.
The system, in its current form under the law, is arduous, as significant administrative time and resources are expended on processing payments of traffic tickets, notwithstanding the burden also placed on the motorist.
This new legislation is welcome as it allows the judiciary to concentrate on its core business of conducting case management and trials. The U-turn system provides real-time connectivity between the courts, licensing division, and the Trinidad and Tobago Police Service. The Traffic Enforcement Center will facilitate electronic secure transfer of video and photographic evidence and information to the judiciary in the form of an electronic case file. This file will provide the judicial officer with all the information relevant to adjudicate a case dispute. On conclusion of the court hearing, the outcome of the matter will be electronically transmitted through the U-turn system to the Traffic Enforcement Center to record the court's order on the driving record of the driver.
Motorists will file their notice to contest via contest.ttlawcourts.org, and upon doing so, they will answer three short questions which will trigger the system to provide a date, time, and court location where they must appear. The system promises to provide real-time information transfer, resulting in improved customer service. It will ease the administrative burdens currently on the courts and allow district court judges to focus on their core function of case management and trials. Persons can file their notice to contest online, and the court is benefited by only having to deal with matters where genuine dispute arises. Evidence and all supporting documents are transmitted through a secured link between and among the respective agencies.
The U-turn system will assist the administration of justice in Trinidad and Tobago by significantly reducing the backlog of cases and the time it takes to determine disputes. Citizens now stand to benefit from improved customer service and faster delivery of justice.
And the last video will deal with the transformation of the licensing division. Ladies and gentlemen, the U-turn system is also leading the transformation of the licensing division. Citizens can now look forward to the rolling out of a suite of online services where simple transactions will not require taking a day off or perhaps paying a bribe. We are making the U-turn from that as well.
With just over 1 million registered vehicles, 800,000 drivers, and an increased number of day-to-day transactions, the licensing division has not kept up to date with the growing demands for its services. Failed systems, weak business processes, poor data and record management systems without adequate audit trails have resulted in inefficiencies and unethical behavior. The U-turn system has been designed to correct these institutional deficiencies and create a platform to allow for the unveiling of a suite of online services for the citizens of Trinidad and Tobago. The licensing division is mindful that this new legislative reform will create a positive change in the behavior of motorists and therefore increase safety on our nation's roads.
in order for successful and seamless implementation, it cannot be business as usual at the licensing division. The services provided at the division remain as essential today as ever before. However, new needs and rising public expectations demand that the division responds promptly, proactively, and effectively.
In today's world, customers and stakeholders want more efficient ways of doing business that requires less paperwork and red tape. More customers want self-service options and increased opportunity to conduct business online. And employees want and need better tools to more effectively serve their customers. Over the last 3 years, the transformation process has begun. Connectivity. The ministry has implemented a number of key ICT initiatives towards revamping the operational procedures of the licensing division. Some of these initiatives have resulted in the full connectivity of all licensing divisions across Trinidad and Tobago.
In fact, these ICT initiatives afforded the ministry the opportunity to revamp its digitization exercise for both driver's permits and vehicle records. Currently, I am pleased to say the digitization exercise is approximately 85% completed.
Data centralization. The licensing division has since migrated all driver's permits and vehicle records.
This information is stored in a Tier 3 data center, which now provides centralized access to all licensing offices.
Certified copies. The licensing division was successful in decentralizing the production of certified copies in both Trinidad and in Tobago. Certified copies are currently available at 4 locations with the intent to expand to all locations.
No longer would citizens be required to request a certified copy in Tobago or in South Trinidad and have that request routed to one location for processing and printing. And this is great news for customers, as it will shorten wait time significantly.
Driver's permits. Centralized access to the driver's permit system provides the licensing division with the opportunity to implement a new driver's permit with state-of-the-art security features, therefore paving the way for modern services and enhanced law enforcement. Online service. Citizens can now access their vehicle records and driver's permit records through an online portal on the ministry's website for the purpose of data verification.
This means over 8,000 transactions were conducted without customers having to visit a licensing office.
Modernization of the vehicle registration system. The ministry will be upgrading its vehicle registration processes to allow for direct integration with the Trinidad and Tobago Customs Division.
This will provide real-time validation of the Customs Division import documents. Vehicle dealers will have the opportunity to upload key documents for registration via an online portal, which will facilitate an electronic pre-registration approval process.
Modernization of the driver's permit system. The ministry recognizes the need to modernize the driver's permit system, especially where the new fixed penalty ticketing system carries with it penalties related to sanctions and demerit points on the records of errant drivers. This new system will provide the opportunity for online applications for learner's permits, online scheduling for regulations on driving tests, computerized exams with secure access, GPS plotting for vehicles used for driving tests, and online renewal processing for driver's permits. Modernization of the electronic vehicle inspection system. The U-turn system provides connectivity between private inspection centers and the vehicle registration database. This means that once your vehicle is validly registered, there would be no need to first obtain a certified copy from the licensing division as a prerequisite to have your vehicle inspected.
This system will also introduce the use of machine-readable inspection stickers, making law enforcement much easier, as well as the mitigation of corrupt practices.
online certified copy request and delivery system. This system will allow citizens the opportunity to request and pay for certified copies online from the comfort of their homes and offices, and have the certified copy delivered by TT Post Courier to a place of choice such as their home, workplace, or TT Connect Center. Electronic Point of Sale System. The electronic point of sale system would provide the benefit of self-pay at several licensing offices.
This system will provide further opportunities to streamline human resources, allowing staff to serve the public in other areas.
Secure Motor Vehicle Number Plate System. The transformation of the licensing division will involve the introduction of a secure motor vehicle number plate system. It will also provide an opportunity for specialized sequential numbers as well as personalized number plates. Introduction of mobile services. The licensing division also intends to launch a mobile service unit which will carry out scheduled visits to rural communities and villages.
These mobile units will be fully equipped with all the necessary technology to allow for the printing of certified copies, processing of learner's permits, renewal of driver's permits, regulation tests for all classes, and renewal of taxi badges.
The Ministry of Works and Transport is steadfast in its course to transform the licensing division. Rest assured, your licensing division will be an exemplar of government service through innovation and delivery of exceptional customer service by empowered and motivated employees. We encourage you to be a part of this journey as we work together to build a Trinidad and Tobago we can all be proud of.
Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to thank Mr. Marvin Gonzalez for that informative, comprehensive, and quite professional presentation. Thank you very much, Mr. Gonzalez. You may decode, maestro.
La ba da 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 la da la da 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 la da da. Well, it gives me the greatest pleasure to introduce the hardest working minister. Ladies and gents, may I be so bold? He was voted best minister in a poll. The economy may not be the best, but this man has been known to do more with less. The man behind this U-turn transformation, the Minister of Works and Transport, Mr. Rohan Sinanan.
No, I mean, all my colleagues are hardworking. I may be the best-looking minister, I think, but the success is that I have the best team of public servants working at the Ministry of Works and Transport. Before I start, I just want to recognize, I didn't see him, but I just want to congratulate Mr. Gosain, our former transport commissioner. Mr. Gosain would have gone on pre-retirement leave, I think it was Monday, and I just want to thank Mr. Gosain for being a part of this transformation. He was very instrumental in the start, and also I want to congratulate our new transport commissioner, Mr. Clark. I think you saw his presentation earlier. The Honorable Faris Alwari, Attorney General, all my cabinet colleagues. In the essence of time, I'd recognize all my cabinet colleagues. The Honorable Adrian Leons, my parliamentary secretary, other parliamentary secretaries, Ms. Sonia Francis Earwood, as I always say, the best permanent secretary in Trinidad and Tobago. Other permanent secretaries, deputy permanent secretaries, representative of the Commissioner of Police, His Worship Alderman Joel Martinez, Mayor of Port of Spain, all other distinguished mayors and councillors, Ms. Nadia Frank John, representative of the Tobago House of Assembly, Ms. Sharon Inglefield, president of Arrive Alive, and someone who ensures that I keep in touch with what is happening on the roads in Trinidad and Tobago on a daily basis. Head of divisions of the Ministry of Works and Transport, specially invited guests, members of the media, ladies and gentlemen, on this salutations, they said good morning. I'm sure we are way past that. Today, as we officially launch the U-turn system, it is my pleasure to announce that we have transitioned into a new era. Today marks the end of an old era in Trinidad and Tobago that had served its purpose. On this 22nd day of January in the year 2020, we are closing a period in time characterized by outdated systems, weak business processes, and poor data and record management practices, devoid of audit trails, and that which facilitated numerous corrupt practices. Thanks to the team of technocrats of the Ministry of Works and Transport and the efforts of our valid stakeholders, we have now opened a new chapter in the building of a new society, one that centers itself on the security and safety of every citizen and the eradication of failed processes by a modernization drive that brings public service closer to the people. The eloquent and informative speakers that have gone before me have outlined the abundance of benefit we as citizens will experience as a result of the new groundbreaking U-turn technological systems. There's very little that I can add, but simply to inform you that the train of transformation temporarily stopped today to deliver some passengers. However, the journey of transportation continues. And today, I want to share with you some of the exciting things you can look forward to in the short to medium term. For we in the Ministry of Works and Transport have long recognized that the work we do have widespread positive implications, not just for us in the ministry, but throughout the length and breadth of the wider national community. As we ponder today on these changes that are about to happen in Trinidad and Tobago, I invite you to remember the tragic road accidents that involved the loss of national footballer Shadron Winchester and three others on the Solomon Holchoy Highway shortly before Christmas last year. In Tobago, the first road fatality in our nation for the year 2020 was Tory Ramsey, only 20 of Mount St. George, young people who could have contributed so much to national development. Ladies and gentlemen, the World Health Organization summarized that road deaths and injuries are sudden, violent, and traumatic experiences. Indeed, they are always traumatic, and yet grief and impact are long-lasting and often permanent. Unfortunately for us in Trinidad and Tobago, young men represent the majority of fatal road traffic victims. According to the statistics from the Trinidad and Tobago Police Service, and we can all agree that the death of a family member, especially a breadwinner, also means the death of an entire family, financially and otherwise. In instances of serious injury, funds must be invested into therapy and rehabilitation costs for all victims. What is more disheartening is the burden that road traffic accidents tend to have on the health and social sector in poor and higher income countries. While you may have heard that the statistics for road traffic deaths in Trinidad and Tobago have decreased considerably, it is imperative that we work continuously towards bringing the statistics closer to zero. 13 years ago, the Ministry of Works and Transport introduced the operationalization laws dealing with the use of seat belts, child booster seat, breathalyzer tests, mobile phones, and speed guns. These efforts resulted in a decrease in road deaths of over 50%. This is clear evidence that our efforts have been effective by creating a road network that is safer and one that brings more fathers, mothers, children, and loved ones back home safely from their daily routine. Indeed, today marks a significant milestone in our process, but the journey also continues. In the coming months, the citizens can look forward to the rollout of further groundbreaking initiatives that will improve the service being offered at the licensing authority and make our roads safer. These include the introduction of one, the mobile bus service, a bus service to bring licensing service directly into the rural communities. Why should our brothers and sisters who reside in rural communities like Toko and Charlottesville have to journey long distance to city centers and towns to conduct simple transactions? With this digitalization efforts within the licensing division, we intend to launch the licensed bus service in the coming months to serve all rural communities across Trinidad and Tobago. Two, the disabled parking. Running parallel to our efforts to create greater access to service while improving public safety and security, the Ministry is currently undertaking further amendments to the Motor Vehicle and Road Traffic Act that will establish a disabled accessible parking system and the standardization of parking facilities for persons who are differently able. Government statistics demonstrate that approximately 4% of the population identified as disabled. With the growing proliferation of motor vehicles on our roads, parking spaces that are closest to any desired destination are obviously the most coveted at malls, offices, and other public places of interest. In this regard, it is far too common parking in spaces that should be exclusively reserved for disabled persons. In this regard, the Ministry will ensure that we have a proper regulatory system in place to ensure that our fellow citizens who are differently able are fully integrated into our society at all levels, including accessibility to parking. Ladies and gentlemen, if we want to build a new society, we must also take care of the most vulnerable in our society. Three, vehicle tinting. Another issue currently receiving our attention is vehicle tinting in Trinidad and Tobago. Obviously, we are not happy about the subjective nature in which the law is being applied, especially the non-scientific method of determining breach of the law and the numerous questions being asked about its enforcement. Therefore, we intend to establish a clear regulatory framework for vehicle tinting in Trinidad and Tobago that will see the use of tint meters by law enforcement officers to determine whether a driver is in breach of the proposed regulation. This will also assist the Trinidad and Tobago Police Service in the relentless fight against crime at all levels, since this matter is not only a road safety issue, we recognize it to be a national security as well. The legal team of the Ministry of Works and Transport and the Ministry of the Attorney General have already prepared and laid the bill for these initiatives, as well as the introduction of RFID license plates on all motor vehicles in Trinidad and Tobago, and to have a world-class vehicle registration system in this country. RFID stands for the radio frequency identification. It is a chip embedded in the license plate that allows law enforcement to accurately identify the vehicles. It is not a tracking device, but it provides an opportunity for the authority to easily identify a stolen vehicle or a vehicle that was involved in the commissioning of a crime or some other traffic offending violation. RFID chips include the inscription of a secured ID code that prevents tampering, cloning, and other forms of fraudulent practice involved in the use of motor vehicle. And as a ministry, we intend to stop this perverse practice as we seek to reconstruct the new society for all law-abiding citizens. This technology will significantly help to combat incidents of vehicle theft and all associated crimes. 5, drugalizer. We will also move with haste to finalize the policy and legislation to deal with drug-impaired drivers. By this, I refer to the introduction of the drugalizer for use by law enforcement officers to ensure that the recent decriminalization of marijuana persons do not endanger the lives of others by the use of dangerous drugs. Ladies and gentlemen, all of these initiatives have one common purpose: building a society around the ideals of safety, security, greater service to the public, further access to opportunities, and a higher standard of living for all. In conclusion, today's launch marks a new chapter in Trinidad and Tobago commitment to road safety and improving customer service for all citizens. I thank the tremendous efforts of all involved, including our allies from the Judiciary of Trinidad and Tobago, the Trinidad and Tobago Police Service, TT Post, the Attorney General's Office, and the hardworking staff of the Ministry of Works and Transport for their passion and vision to making this a reality. I am proud of each of you. Your country is grateful to you for your contribution to national development. You have overcome the naysayers and the doubters, and today you stand as a beacon of hope for all citizens. Congratulations on a job well done. To you, our dear guests, and those following us live on television, I thank you for your support, and I invite each of you to become an ambassador to this U-turn journey. And let's offer our country an array of hope for a brighter tomorrow. I thank you. May God bless you, and may God bless Trinidad and Tobago. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this point in time, I'd like to invite Minister to return center stage. I would also like to invite the Permanent Secretary in the Ministry of Works and Transport to come center stage, Ms. Sharon Ingerfield, Mr. Adrian Winter, Mr. Marvin Gonzalez, and Mr. Clive Clark. So we invite center stage, ladies and gentlemen. At this point in time, we would just like to take a moment to remember all the victims who would have lost their lives in tragic road accidents. And we have a candle which represents a burning torch for the Ministry of Works and Transport that we would like to hand over to Ms. Sharon Ingerfield to encourage her in her fight and her work for road safety in Trinidad and Tobago. And this also represents the Ministries of Works and the Ministry of Works and Transport's commitment to working with Arrive Alive and any other agency as we push forward for greater road safety in Trinidad and Tobago. We believe that every life matters, and we should all take responsibility in being road safe. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
And ladies and gentlemen, we expect this new system to take effect from the 2nd of March, 2020. What we are doing today is to roll out the entire marketing strategy, and this will continue, and we expect to go live from the 2nd of March, 2020. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, As we draw near to the end of today's proceedings, I would like to take this opportunity just to inform you about our educational campaign. I invite you to visit www.drivingtt.com. It's a website that provides you with all the information on this project. Public education is very important, and we want you to have access to that information. We're also inviting you to get a copy of today's newspapers. The ministry is front and center, telling you about the transformation of the licensing division and the licensing department. You have your role to play. Get in the know. Stay tuned to all of our channels, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, our new website, which will be launched shortly, as well as our microsite, for all of the information, and feel free to contact us. We are here to serve you. At this point in time, it's my pleasure to introduce the coordinator of the Traffic Enforcement Center. You would have seen him starring on the screen, and he's very vibrant and very active in this project, but saying thanks is very important, because it takes a lot of time, it takes a lot of work, and this was quite a journey. Let's give him a warm welcome as we bring today's proceedings to a close with a vote of thanks.
Good afternoon, everyone. That is the former me. Senator, the Honorable Rohan Sinanan, Minister of Works and Transport, the Honorable Faris Awari, Attorney General of the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago, Honorable Ministers, His Excellency Bruce Lendon, Australian High Commissioner for Trinidad and Tobago, the Honorable Adrian Leons, Parliamentary Secretary in the Ministry of Works and Transport, other parliamentary secretaries, Mrs. Sonia Francis Yearwood, Permanent Secretary in the Ministry of Works and Transport, and other permanent secretaries and deputy permanent secretaries, Commissioner of Transport, Mr. Clive Clark, representative of the Commissioner of Police, other mayors and councillors, Mrs. Nadia Frank John, representative of the Division of Infrastructure, Quarries and the Environment in the Tobago House of Assembly, heads of division and the Ministry of Works, specially invited guests, members of the media, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon once again. Is it possible to build improved space management approaches to ensure safe operations in outer space? I'm not trying to sound airy-fairy. A panel of experts in the field said yes. It will require more transparency among satellite operators, meaning more information is required to adequately create such a system. Here in Trinidad and Tobago, we have built a traffic enforcement system geared to ensure greater safety on the nation's roads. It assures law enforcement agencies enhanced efficiencies in the management of those who offend in the use of the road. We have heard our most august speakers outline to you the details of the system's operations and the many benefits of bringing such technology into the mainstream use. We are not far behind any of the other countries who have built the technology or who have been using it for a longer time. All administrators of road usage now possess a greater situational awareness of what is happening on our roads, and this enhances our ability as a society to lift the ante in refining how we approach road use. Of course, this is not the final frontier in terms of technology used to manage vehicular traffic and road safety, but we have, in fact, advanced very far along the spectrum, and it is my simple task today to acknowledge those who have got us here to give encouragement as we continue to steer the course. Is it indeed very important to say thank you, beginning with that moving and powerful invocation by Ms. Louise Leoto. Ms. Leoto, we thank you. To our Permanent Secretary, Mrs. Sonia Francis Yearwood, who warmly welcomed us here this morning. Madam PS, on behalf of the Ministry of Works and Transport team, we say a heartfelt thank you for your continued leadership in ensuring the ministry remains a strong, committed, innovative, client-centered, well-respected institution to the social and economic development of the people of Trinidad and Tobago. The most compelling driver for some of the relevant bodies and agencies to contribute toward a traffic management solution was to create a significant reduction in the number of road fatalities. There have been stakeholders who were driven by very little else, and it is a noble objective. The fact that you never tire or retreat in the face of what must be difficult personal trauma, to speak in very strident tones for things to improve traffic management and enforcement, is a constant reminder that systematic traffic management was a necessity, a very urgent necessity. For this, we acknowledge the contributions and say thank you to Mrs. Sharon Inglefield and her team at Arrive Alive and other similar stakeholders. To His Excellency Bruce London and the staff of the High Commission for Australia, who worked diligently with the ministry in the development of this system, we say a heartfelt thank you. Special mention must be made of His Excellency John Pilbeam, the former High Commissioner, for his work. The use of the road is a highly legislated activity, and we can sometimes forget that if we never run afoul of the law using the road. In this light, it would be remiss of me if I did not extend much gratitude and recognition to the staff of the Legal Services Unit, the Information and Communication Technology Unit, and the Traffic Management Branch of the Ministry of Works and Transport. You are part of the rubber that hits the road. You represent the engine room of operations in controlling the traffic environment. Special mention and recognition must be made of Mr. Marvin Gonzalez and Mr. Clive Clark for your diligent work over the years in crafting various pieces of legislation and developing first-world ICT infrastructure. As you all have seen, ladies and gentlemen, there are many operational levels in this system, and it is to these bodies that we now turn our attention. The fulfillment of this goal to have a traffic management system of such sophistication would not have been possible without the following agencies. We acknowledge your commitment and professionalism and express sincere gratitude to Mr. Leon Leslie and your team from Shirami Limited for the development of this first world technological platform. Mr. George Nicholas and the team from the Trinidad and Tobago Postal Corporation, a partnership that embodies the true meaning of teamwork makes the dream work. Dr. Simon Alexis, the Provost of the Police Training Academy, Dean Nizam Ali and your team from the Police Training Academy, we say thank you. Mr. Brent Batson and the team from the Trinidad and Tobago Police Service that would have included Sergeant Philip and Sergeant Harilal, thank you for your unwavering support and the embracing of this initiative. The staff of the Office of the Attorney General and Ministry of Legal Affairs, we say thank you. The Central Planning Unit of the Ministry, Ms. Shirley Chinslick and the team from the Human Resource Management Division, Mr. Kelvin Mapp and the staff of the Licensing Transformation Unit, Ms. Kizzy Ruiz and the Communications Unit, the Public Management Consulting Division of the Ministry of Public Administration, the Comptroller of Accounts in the Ministry of Finance, the Office of Law Enforcement Policy, and I must pay special mention to Mr. Curtis Belfort for all his assistance as it relates to the recruitment of the staff in the Traffic Enforcement Center, the Trinidad and Tobago Defense Force, who assisted us with the polygraph testing, the Auditor General's Department, NIPDEC, and all the other agencies that would have assisted. The expert contributions from the judiciary of Trinidad and Tobago must be acknowledged. We are deeply appreciative of the support and assistance in working towards creating the system in full compliance with the law. Special mention to Chief Magistrate Her Worship Maria Busby Earl Cadell, Magistrates Duane Murray and Sonara Toon McQuilkin, Master Christian Morris Allen and the other court executive administrators, and last but certainly not least, the director of ICT, Ms. Carol Herbert, and her team, we thank you. Then there are the impassioned lawmakers. They are driven to create order, order that provides the parameters that engender safety and peaceful coexistence for all road users. They refuse to see obstacles as barriers and work around significant pushback and objection to achieve an aim that benefits everyone. In this light, again, it would be remiss of me if I did not publicly acknowledge the work of the former Minister of Works and Transport, the Honorable Fitzgerald Hines. His tenacious desire to see the establishment of this center motivated him to valiantly encounter all objections and still advance the work to make the center more than a concept, but advance to a reality. The day is here, Honorable Minister. It must give you significant satisfaction to see it, and we thank you. The final thrust, the visionary leadership, the energized continuance of the effort by the Honorable Rohan Sinanan, our Minister of Works and Transport, was continued encouragement to all of us who were involved in this process. His drive, his enthusiasm, the momentum he created was critical to moving this project along. I am sure you all will join me in saying a resounding thank you to the Honorable Minister of Works and Transport. Then there is the office holder who must champion this ideal, on whose shoulders it falls to take this cause to Parliament and persuade and convince lawmakers that this is a purpose that needs legislating. The fiery discussions that must ensue to establish buy-in. We must appreciate the skill and energy of our Attorney General, the Honorable Faris Alwari. Sir, understand that we have appreciated your dedication to this task, and we thank you. To our very entertaining and lively MCs, Ms. Kizzy Ruiz and Black Sage, we thank you for a job well done. For those of you who did not hear a specific mention or did not feel some appreciation, I take full responsibility for any such omissions and say a humble thank you for all that you have contributed to this project and ensuring today is a success. On behalf of the Honorable Minister, the Permanent Secretary, I thank you all for your attendance and for taking the time to share this pivotal moment with us today. Thank you, thank you, thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you very much for that wonderful vote of thanks, sir. Court maestro. You looked at the presentation. I know you see we are now all around with technology. You looked at the things and you realize everything in transport now computerized. So you know I cannot complain. No more shortcoming in the transport system again. I feel so very proud of us. Trinbago is achieving world-class status.
Ladies and gentlemen, this brings us to the end of today's proceedings. A special thanks to the man, Black Sage.
Thank you very much.
Black Sage, I will try to do an extempo, but no. I will stick to the talking, you stick to the singing, right?
She's one of the great voices in Calypso, eh? She's one of the very great voices in Calypso. Although I heard an officer here singing, the sergeant who sang, man, that lady is wonderful.
So ladies and gentlemen, thank you, thank you, thank you. This is the beginning of a very exciting journey. We have some light refreshments for you. Do stay back, socialize, talk, chat about our revolution and the transformation that's taking place. And don't forget to visit our website, www.drivingtt.com.
Well, you've been tuned to a live broadcast on TTT, Talk City 91.1 FM and TTT Live Online of a conference hosted by the Ministry of Works and Transport titled driving towards transformation, introducing revolutionary traffic enforcement systems aimed at promoting road safety. And to remind you, some of those measures to be implemented are the demerit point system, the new fixed penalty traffic ticketing system, and the red light camera enforcement system. And according to Minister of Works and Transport, Rohan Sunanan, these systems will be expected to be introduced on March 2nd, 2020.